13 inches of snow in Boston, the most snow this city has seen in about 3 years, of some 17 inches in some parts of Massachusetts. But the real story, the flooding. This is Boston Harbor, and yesterday it saw its highest tide in nearly 40 years. It pushed about 2 to 3 feet of water over that ridge over there where you see the New England Aquarium and into downtown, flooding the aquarium subway station. Take a look at this video. This is water going down the aquarium subway station. The fire commissioner saying he had never seen the water go that far into downtown. But you know what? It wasn't just that. It was also all throughout Seaport Boulevard and the waterfront in Boston. Look, the full moon combined, the super moon combined with the weather yesterday caused the highest tide, eclipsing perhaps the 1978 blizzard. Just an astronomical high tide which caused this flooding. You could take a look at this photo. Fire rescue actually had to save some cars that were stuck, people that were stuck in their vehicles in the slushy, icy water. 32 coastal communities at least saw some significant flooding in and around southeastern Massachusetts. The National Guard had to be called in to save several families that were inundated in 3 to 4 foot slushy water. And if you take a look at this photo, this is Duxbury, Massachusetts. You can see those cars frozen in that salty water. And if you look back here behind me at Boston Harbor here, you see that building over there? That's the Boston Cruise Harbor Lines there. That building, we spoke to somebody. They saw some 16 inches of slushy cold water come into that building. The person said they had never seen that before. They've been here since 1967. Logan Airport, by the way, seeing over 200 cancellations today. They are urging people to call their airlines. There is a residual effect from those cancellations and that weather yesterday.
Wow. Here comes the freeze, too. Thank you, Brian Yenis, there in the cold today.